the reason why I wrote about Mr. Roberts is because he helped me not only in school with, you know, educationally, but he helped me spiritually as well.
Elizabeth is a very deep thinker. What she'll do is she'll take something that you say, whether it's in the class or something that's off of tangent, and she'll think about it, and she'll apply it to herself, which is what makes her such a great student. Because that's really what we want to do as teachers. We can introduce the materials to them, but the real bottom line is we want them to learn it. We want them to feel it. We want them to understand it. We don't want just etch-a-sketch learning type things. We want them to understand why they're doing what they're doing and then apply it.
Through the mists of proofs and functions, Mr. Roberts always exuded a soothing energy. He was always there for anyone in need of help, educationally and personally. He taught my class not only important skills in math, but also important skills in life. I went through a lot of stuff during my freshman year, like just with my family, and it was a tough time for me. But it seemed like it was a lot easier because Mr. Roberts taught me how to rise above that, rise above all the ordeals and just live my life. And that's what I did.
I don't want to just teach the math. I want to teach the kids. And I found out that they really want to hear it, which surprised me. They want to do well in school and they want to get to good grades. But these kids so badly want to learn about whether they're going in the right direction and whether they're appreciated and whether they're good enough and what they can do to be happy. And if you're going to teach in this day and age, you have to incorporate that.
One of the things that he does exceptionally well is he connects. You know, you walk into his room and you notice immediately that there's a connection, you know. And it's kids that are attentive and they're following him with everything he says. And I think at the end of the day, when kids leave his class, they've learned a lot about math and they've learned a lot about life, and both of those things, you know, are good things, and that's really what he represents.
He put the simple idea of how life is good into my head long ago when I was a pubescent child in need. Since then, I have changed my whole perspective on life. I now see the truth about what is most important. He may never know this, but he has saved me from living a life as an empty shell. He taught me how to free my soul from the fetters of daily life. To me, that is the greatest lesson to ever be given.